Yo, what is good, everybody, and thank you so much for stopping by the channel once again from us over here at Locust Wild Honey. It seems like you guys really do enjoy the vlogs a lot more than the sit-down videos, so that's essentially what we're going to be doing today. And when I say we, we got Gabby.
What's up,
finally,
Gabby?
Day off today, looking beautiful. And actually, we started the vlog just now because a package came through.
I got these dad shoes from Paul.
From Daddy, is what you're trying to say, right?
No, I'm not trying to say that.
And how much did we pay for them?
They were only $50.
50 bucks. Shout out Adidas for like this insanely huge packaging. And excuse my mess in my apartment, but here is my pair. Again, better light here. So I went ahead and grabbed my pair. As you can see here, it has like a creamish outsole, kind of giving it kind of like a vintage vibe up top. Pretty sleek and slender, but it is paneled and raised. So it kind of gives it kind of like a chunkier kind of aesthetic. Genuine leather, feels amazing in hand. And for 50 bucks, you can't beat it. I will have a link in the description if you guys do want a pair of these. I think they run at about $60 or $70. They are still on sale. Wow.
Wow.
Pretty nice there, Gabby. And we are off. As you can see, I did break out the moccasins.
So I just found Paul's water bottle in his car. Paul, Fuenteballa. And babe, can you explain to us why you felt the need to label your water bottle?
Like, why are you calling me out over that?
Because who labels their water bottle? Is there anyone out there who labels their hydro flask by their name, like, so everyone can see it?
Well, that's the point though, because like, okay, well, you know, joke's on you, because last week I lost my other hydro flask that didn't have my name on it.
Old water bottle had your name on it. You think that nobody would have stole it?
No, of course not. Okay. How weird would that be? Would you drink a water that said somebody else's name? That's a little weird. Like, what would your
peers
say?
I mean, the question is like, do you really think whoever stole your hydro flask is drinking out of it?
For sure. What, like?
No.
Why would they steal it?
Why would anyone put their mouth on something someone else has put their mouth on?
I mean,
that's so gross.
You put your mouth on me.
That is so dumb, dude.
That came out the wrong way. That doesn't mean the dirty thing.
Did you really just do that?
No, like, that doesn't mean what that means, dude.
Babe.
I'm like...
Oh, my goodness.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Doing well, thanks. All right, guys, so look at this. Okay, so I didn't have my Starbucks app open, okay? I didn't have it open. I haven't opened it in a few days. Dude, I go down to open the menu to get the Starbucks app, it's the first one always there. I think it uses your location services. And it's on all the time. And when you get near a Starbucks, it becomes the first one on your menu.
Here's a strawberry sign.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Is that not like a trip to you? The logo of Starbucks is a siren, and if you guys don't know what that is, that's a mermaid. And the reason why they chose the mermaid is because nobody can not
resist
the call of the siren, you know, like they're singing and stuff like in the movies. And dude, how crazy is that? Like, the app and like everything's working in conjunction to bring you in.
Like, well, is that, it definitely does that.
Dude, how is that not freaking insane to you? That's crazy to me.
We decided to like come up with a plot, like, so we talked about it like away from our phones, what it was. Remember we said it was gonna be a pizza?
No, yeah, pizza.
Yeah, so Paul's like, okay.
Sure enough, dude, within 30 minutes.
So he said he's gonna say, I want a pizza, and we did that. And sure enough, yeah, like he said,
30 minutes.
30 minutes later, the
scrolling
pizza.
Scrolling through Instagram.
Yeah, scrolling through Instagram, the pizza. The pizza
Domino's. The Domino's.
The ad comes up.
The ad comes up.
Yeah. If that's ever happened to you, please leave a comment below. This is getting crazy, you guys. And if anyone knows why this is happening, please, we want to hear your input. Oh, I do.
If you guys don't know, Gabby's a professional dancer. And Gabby, like, can I just play songs randomly and then you have to, like, interpret them and dance?
In the car.
Okay.
Okay, I can only use one hand because I'm using my biceps to hold the camera up, which are very strong because this camera weighs at least 5 pounds.
That's not heavy.
It's heavy, you guys. For me, it's really heavy.
Okay, we're gonna play this game. I'm gonna play songs at random.
Okay.
Like, just random.
Here we
and
go.
You have to interpret them, okay?
I'm gonna try my best. You guys, I only have one hand, so just go with it.
You can't look either. Okay. Okay.
Try and pick something that I kind of am familiar with, though, so it's not super awkward.
Okay, ready? Okay, ready?
Okay. Alright.
Don't look at the song, okay? You just have to you have to dance to it.
Oh, I like this
ready?
One.
Ready?
I saw it, sorry.
Oh. Hey! Get it! Okay! This is talent right here, bro! Are you serious? Are you kidding me? I gotta.
Whew, my leg's now starting to hurt.
Are you having a good time with this?
I'm literally holding the
camera. I'm actually really entertained.
With my leg.
Are you not entertained? I'm entertained. I'm really entertained.
Oh god, my leg. Lord help me. Wait. Okay, that's good.
Ready?
Yep, we got it.
Are you ready?
Wait.
Don't look at the screen.
My toes, they're not able to hold this.
Are you ready? Things that you said to me yesterday. I know you say that I am assuming things. Something's going down, that's the way it seems. Shouldn't be the reason why you're acting strange. Nobody's holding you back from me. Cause I know how you usually do. When you're saying everything to me times two. Alright, I think we have to end it there.
Okay.
People are looking at us very oddly.
We're almost there anyways.
Alright guys, so we just got here to the Orange Circle. One of my favorite places to be when it comes to vintage shopping. Gabby has yet to ever come here before. This is her first time ever. And hopefully she'll have a good time. Is there anything that you have in mind what you're looking for today, Gabs? Nope. Just nope? Alright, let's go ahead and make our way. I need to spill some urine real quick.
I have very low expectations because I have no expectations at all. I'm assuming it's going to smell. I'm assuming there's going to be a lot of clothes. And I'm assuming the lighting is probably going to be really like rather yellow. Probably a little like low lighting in this environment.
Wow, and your expectations are low, dude. Dang.
No, that's what it's
is like
in
anything worse.
That's what it's like in vintage stores from my experience. But you've had more experience, babe. You tell me, what are you expecting?
Not exactly fair because I already know what to expect, but I guess I can kind of explain to you how it's kind of set up. So this is an antique mall, as you can see in the sign, and we're going to Antique Depot right now. We're going to head back over here as well, but with that to say, like, I'm explaining it to you, babe, but also to them. These antique malls are essentially like just spaces that people rent. So things are curated, and like literally pop-up shops are curated by people who go out to like the Rose Bowl and like different places that sell vintage things, and they buy from garage sales and stuff, and they sell it and they resell it here in these different pop-ups and stations. Don't expect like thrift prices, but you can expect like vintage things, if that makes sense. Does that make sense? Well, I mean, if you're thrifting, like, you know, a t-shirt would be like $1, $2, $3. Jackets are like $5. Here you're gonna probably get paid a little bit more of a premium. Like the t-shirt probably be like $15, $20.
Oh, vintage cameras, Gabby. That's neat.
Would you want one for Christmas?
No, thank you.
Okay.
I already have enough cameras.
What about one of these?
What the heck is that?
Ooh.
How about LV?
What the heck? This is a new spot station.
Only $375?
Babe, they're vintage.
Wow. This is actually nice. This is a nice little piece right here with the crossbody chain. How much is that?
$398.
Little vintage Louis.
Wow, they got vintage designer spots now.
Okay.
This place is really, really
cool. They're stepping it up.
Dude,
will you put that on?
No. No.
No, you won't? Please?
No.
This would be so fun.
I don't even know.
You look like a mermaid, like a siren.
Oh my goodness. Okay, I'll do it.
You'll put it on, yes.
For the vlog.
Yes.
They didn't have a dressing room at this place, so.
Babe, you look like a gorgeous princess.
This is the best we could do, guys.
You look like a princess, Gabby.
Thank you.
You look like the lady from Frozen. Princess,
it also doesn't fit.
Elsa.
That moment when you realize it
Gabby,
doesn't
spread
fit.
Spread your wings.
You're like a princess. Okay. Oh, you look like the wife of the Tin Man.
Thank you.
Hey, you want? I'll buy that for you.
Babe, it doesn't fit me. Okay.
Will you put this on? This looks cool. It's a poncho.
Baby.
Yeah?
No.
Why? Okay. This wow. is such a cool. This is so cool.
Look at it, it's like a cookie jar with Cinderella. Man, someone was really in love with Cinderella.
Hey, look at me. This might be the thumbnail. Hey, reach your arm out like you're inviting me to go thrift with you.
Like that?
No, like, yeah, like. You want to come closer to me? Come closer to me. again. I'm spelling.
What?
Ah! Here's mad expensive. I'm like, wow, dude, look at this Mrs. Potts.
Oh, and the little chip.
Little chip, too.
So cute.
This is pretty neat, right, babe?
It really is. It's cool. There's a lot of things that I... Collectibles. A lot of collectibles.
Walk down Robert E. Lane.
Oh, look at this.
Wow, look at that. You got some boxers over there.
Whoa.
That's what you call an antique.
That's an antique? Yeah. Wow.
Hey, can you pull that up? What is that?
Oh, what?
That flannel.
I'm not really big on touching that.
Okay.
Perfect for a dance duet. Look it. Look it.
Can you sit in it? That's kind of scary.
It's like a salon chair, so you start the dance like, you know. Wait. Like this. It's him. They're doing their hair. You know? It's cute, right?
That's actually really fun, but yeah, I wouldn't want that in my house.
Well, no.
That's scary.
It looks like a prop.
Alright guys, so we're heading over to one of my favorite booths, which is actually next door to a booth with only vintage tees, which is right over here. So babe, let's start at the Levi's booth. This is mostly Perfect. Like vintage denim and stuff like that.
Great.
And next door is all vintage tees.
Perfect.
So
this is why we're here.
We're gonna sift through and see what we could find. Oh, they got vintage Levi's shorts, babe. Oh, these are these for boys?
Maybe.
They're pretty big. Are these for guys, dude? Light vintage denim. You guys saw my previous vlogs here. You guys may have seen me purchase a pair. I have this wash already. It's like a medium wash. Pretty sick. But yeah, that might not be it. Oh, this is pretty sick.
That is nice.
It's lined with nylon. Should I throw this on? Oh, it feels, it's very nice quality.
Yeah, hurry, put it on.
Field and Stream.
Come on out, why don't you come on out so we can actually see what's going on here. Okay, baby, here's some fashion.
This
walk,
is...
Fashion walk, catwalk, let's go. Ready? Wow, sexy.
Do you like it or not? Yeah. It's kind of long,
I mean,
dude.
It's definitely big, let's be real, but... The length isn't the issue, it's mainly the arms, in my opinion.
I feel like it's also really long here. Yeah, it looks like a too big.
Okay. Wow.
What?
White jeans, I haven't seen those in a second, for men.
Mmm. Meowmix, please deliver. Alright. Not doing too much for me.
Something tells me you're not really giving all those items a chance.
No, dude. A lot of these are just fugly.
Okay.
That's nice. Hey, buddy. How's it going?
Say hi.
How are you?
Long time no see.
Yeah, I know,
dude.
Friend.
How's it going? Oh, actually, can I get in this case? While you're here?
Great. Here's
all right, cool. Thank you, brother. Alright, so I found a really clean pair, stone wash, pretty sick, has a little bit of aging up front, like some stains and stuff, size 31, so the length is a little bit long, but I probably just get these altered.
We can't see, can you come out?
Yeah, you can't see the,
we can't see the length.
Wash of them. Yeah, they're a little bit on the longer side.
Nice.
But yeah, I could definitely just get these hemmed.
This is a nice angle, baby.
Oh, yeah?
Yep, I can see your mouth. There's your eyes.
So this is where you keep, yeah, this is definitely where he keeps his good stuff. It's all the good sizes. I don't really like this wash that much though. And just for like pricing reference, keep in mind this stuff is curated, so there's gonna be a little bit of a premium that you'll be paying because of the work that it took to get this stuff over here. So all the jeans are roughly around 30 bucks, which I mean, a lot of people will be like, that's not actual vintage shopping, but I mean, it saves us a lot of work, you guys. Got a vintage Harley tee. I don't know, this might be a little bit too much. What do you think,
babe? I like it, but.
You like it?
I don't really see you wearing something like that, but I definitely would. I like it. Can you come out here with that?
Yeah, sure. Do you want it?
Maybe.
It's a medium.
Let me see.
It's a size medium, so it's definitely your size, because I take an XL.
I like that one.
All right, so here's the tee on.
Looks cute.
Like I said, some slight cracking on the back, up front.
I feel like it looks pretty nice.
Yeah, this is definitely a really old one because it is single stitched, as you can see.
Or is that a stain? Like, can we just...
Okay, that is also actually
He goes, it's single stitch, and then he points out the stain.
That was an accident. I actually just grabbed a random part of it.
It's definitely vintage, and it's definitely old because there's a stain here from grandma's pudding. You know what I mean?
All right, guys, so I found a pretty sick pair of denim.
You sound so excited.
I found a really sick pair of denim. There's people around. 501, that's going to be the fit of them. We're going to throw them on. The size on these is a waist of a 30, but yeah, when denim is washed so many times over time, it will shrink. So these probably won't fit, but let's give them a try. They don't fit, like they're too, I mean, I like how they fit in terms of like everything else, but they won't button. I would show you, but I mean,
yeah. It's okay,
but it's okay. This is a 30. No, I mean, it just goes to show, dude. Like,
it just goes to show, don't eat if you want to fit in size 30 jeans.
Dude, I'm a size 30 in normal stuff.
Uh-huh, what are you talking about? It's okay.
Yeah, like, you're not being funny, you're just being mean.
I'm not being mean.
Yeah, you are. Like, I feel really, like, offended. I'm just kidding. I'm literally just kidding.
This is, like, so uncomfortable. Yeah, So are they.
How's this?
That looks great, actually.
Honest?
I like it. It looks like a holiday jacket. You could wear that for the party.
Are you teasing?
No, I'm not. I like, well...
What's the top dollar you'd pay for this? It's wool.
Like
it's 100% wool.
I have to say I like it, but...
Wool with silk lining.
It's kind of strange to wear that in California, I would see, but...
Oh, you're actually true.
But in New York,
but
that would look
this
great.
This would look sick with, like, a hoodie underneath.
I like it. It definitely is
all right, what's
the
top dollar you'd pay for it? And then if...
50.
You pay 50?
Yeah, I would.
Wow.
How much is it?
It's only 28.
Well, then I guess you're getting it.
So this is why you sift through boxes. So I was just like rummaging through like the bottom. Here's a bunch of clothes on the ground and in these boxes back there. And I found a vintage crew neck, a Nike one. Well, actually, dude, I think this might be a bootleg because...
The Nike sign?
Yeah, this is not the Nike sign. I think this is New Balance, isn't it?
No, the logo's there, isn't it?
The little check.
A little check mark?
I don't know. I mean, it might be authentic. I'm not sure. But,
It looks authentic.
You think so? Okay. Well, this thing's actually kind of fire. I like the color, and it has, like, it looks like it's been bleached. Let's see.
Oh, that's nice.
Do you like it?
I do. You should get that one.
20 bucks?
Get it.
For sure?
Yeah.
Wow, see, like, that's when you know Gabby likes it for sure, is when, like, quick affirmative. Like, everything else has been non-committal.
Yep.
But, babe, for sure, like, fit and everything, like...
Yeah, it looks great, babe.
Does it look like something I'd wear?
Yeah, actually, it does. It doesn't look like Nike, though, now that I look closer at
it. It looks like New Balance, doesn't it?
I don't know New Balance.
Oh, okay.
But it definitely, it looks like a knockoff.
I'm actually into it. I like it. Not bad, not bad.
Yeah, that's a cop.
It's a cop. 20 bucks. So just next door from the Levi's, we are at the vintage tea station.
That's right.
And just kind of sifting through.
I feel like you'd like this.
That's actually fire, babe. Hold on, can I show the fade on that?
All right.
Size XL Toltext. This is actually a good find, babe. 15 bucks.
Do you like it?
Yeah, wait, do you want it for you? Wow, isn't she just the best girlfriend ever?
I try.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna get this with you. Yeah, thanks. That's a good find. That's a good find.
Hey, babe.
This is a red dog shirt. I could see you actually wearing something like this, babe.
Oh, okay.
So would you wear that?
That's actually pretty sick, and the wash is really dope. But I personally like a little bit more front graphic than just like on the like the crest.
The corner.
Yeah, just on the front, on the chest.
That is said Chino. Ohio State.
Yeah.
Arizona.
I actually like that tee a little bit.
You like Arizona?
Yeah, but it just doesn't have
1997, to go let's go.
So it was in 97. How old is that shirt?
This is 27 years old. That's right. Isn't that right?
Really?
20 years old. Sorry, 20 years old. Jeez. Well, don't do that. That's not funny. This is actually pretty cool.
Reggae. You're such a dorkus.
Hey, baby.
Oh, that's actually fire. Nah.
Nah. Cowboys.
Heck nah. Say heck nah.
Why heck nah?
Because we don't like the Cowboys.
Ooh, this one's nice.
Oh, that fade.
Oh my goodness. That's, babe, I think this is the single stitch, right?
Actually, wait. It is. Good eye, hon.
It is.
Why? All right. That is a great find, actually.
Would you wear this?
I would wear that.
$28.
28.
That's nice.
I know I'm gonna get this. You know why?
Why?
Jacob Keller is a huge Portland Trailblazers fan. One of my good friends on YouTube.
YouTube.
And I think, I honestly think he would love this.
Who is he?
Jacob.
Jacob.
Jacob Keller. Always fresh apparel?
Always fresh.
He is always fresh. No, actually, he's actually.
Okay, babe,
fresh.
So let's put that to the pile of the goat. Let's like, we're get getting
that.
These.
Okay, let's get that.
Okay. Okay. Where do you want to put it?
Just throw in the pile.
All
right. Good find.
Thanks, babe. High five.
Okay. Yeah. See, now you know what you're looking for, too, if you ever go vintage shopping for me, like when you're bored and stuff.
Totally. It's your life. It's worth a sunny.
Wait, what do you think about this? This actually has a cool fade to it. It's like cream. But I like the color of it. Wow. So mean to me.
I'm sorry, you guys.
Whoa. Wait, what is this? I just like the distressing on there.
I like this one too, actually.
The distressing.
This one's cool.
What is that?
I don't know, but it's cool.
Oh, no.
Oh, my goodness. We're...
Oh, wait.
Wait, Illuminati.
Yeah. Behind me, Satan.
Frustrated.
Average?
Wait, actually? What do you think about this?
This is more our style.
The church. You're so... That shouldn't be a laughing matter, actually.
No, it's just funny.
That's... Honest thoughts.
That's actually nice.
Yeah, I actually like it too. The wash of it is really cool.
This is a cop,
babe. $12. Feel it.
This feels okay.
Hanes Beefy Tea.
Simplicity. It's the key to brilliance.
DJ Khaled. Really? Diamond collab.
I like DJ Khaled.
We'll go.
Wait, how does it do?
What the heck? We the best.
We the best music. We the best music.
Wait, how does he say it?
We the best. Oh.
We the best music.
Is that right? I don't know.
Beep, beep,
beep. Beep, beep, beep. Oh, yeah. I like it.
Oh, you're what about this vintage little girl? Nike.
What about this one?
Ugly so Christmas sweater.
Oh, it's only $10.
What the heck, dude? Babe?
That's cool.
What?
That's sick, dude.
Dude, I want that one. Dude, what?
I want that one.
This can't be real. It's only 25. Oh, yeah, fake. Yeah, see? At least they're honest. Fake bootleg babe. Oh!
Hello.
Oh, wow. That actually fits you quite nicely, honey.
This is for our ugly sweater holiday party. I like it.
Gabby. No matter how ugly the sweater.
Oh no, here it goes, here it goes, here it comes. You set it up.
You always sexy.
He set it up.
You always sexy, girl. You always sexy, girl.
He's dancing. You can't see from behind. He's like this. He's like this in the back.
A little ACDC.
I like this.
25. That's a high ask. Oh wow, there's a whole bunch of them, huh?
But it's green.
I like it.
Can you try it on?
I can try it on.
Let's try it on. Why not?
I can try it.
Let's try it.
It's right here.
Oh yeah, huh? I actually like the green one though. The green one doesn't look nice on you, with your complexion.
Thanks, baby.
That's actually a nice find, babe. It actually looks really cool. Yeah, that's a very 90s outfit. Yeah. But how much are they asking?
I don't know.
If there's this many, that means they're asking a lot.
Cash price, 15.
15?
It's cheaper than my Harley Davidson shirt.
How about this? Big? How about I buy that for you?
No.
I'll buy that for you.
No.
You can get the t-shirt. I'll buy this for you.
Do you like it that much?
I do like it that much. It looks really nice on you. I think it looks really cool. It's like very, very 90s. You look very 90s right now.
All right, guys, so that's gonna do it for our first stop. I feel like Antique Depot was a major success. Definitely got a few really cool tees as well as a potential gift. And yeah, I feel like we're having a good day so far. Gabby found a couple of things as well.
So far, so good, you guys.
Which actually, I won't lie, Gabs, I was a bit hesitant. I wasn't sure that you'd be into like the vintage stuff, but I'm really glad you're open to all of it.
I am, as long as it doesn't smell.
Got some good stuff, babe. I'm excited. You're already wearing a new jacket.
Yep.
I only spent like $60-something. Not too bad.
Good job, babe.
Yeah, because a lot of this stuff was on sale, surprisingly enough. Definitely a vibe. Now we have to decide where we're gonna eat, which is like
the hardest
thing for us ever.
Where we at, babe?
We're at Earth Cafe, you guys. But I ordered this chicken pesto sandwich and Paul and I are gonna split. So half the pizza is gonna be mine and half the chicken pesto
is
his.
We never agreed to this.
We did. In line, he's like, can I have some of your pesto? And so I said,
can I have
okay.
a bite?
So,
I didn't say
know.
Half of my pizza.
Yeah.
She sees the pizzas, now she wants half.
Yep. That's the truth.
Strong. Strong latte.
You point to it. Strong.
Anyways, we're going to enjoy our lunch right now.
It's beautiful.
Thanks so much for joining us today. Gabby, yep. So far, so good. You enjoying today?
So far, I've had a lot of fun, actually. So, thank you.
You look so nice in your new jacket, babe.
Thank you, baby.
All right, let's go ahead and eat up.
Is it on?
Yeah. I still think we're walking. Can you just back up a little bit more? Let's take one corner. Right there. And like kind of walk this way. So they...
Right? Why walking?
That's a thumbnail.